Hey, it's Chris, and I just put together my ultimate console gaming setup, and that includes an amazing TV, the best pro controller, the best pro headset, and the best gaming chair, which, yeah, that's a thing, a living room gaming chair. Maybe you didn't know that. And by the way, best is with a question mark, because I'm here to tell you if these things that I thought were the best actually are the best. So here's the plan today. I want to tell you why I picked what I picked, what do I think about these things, and would I recommend them to you for your setup, and also can any of these things actually make you a better gamer. And of course, if I'm talking too fast again and you guys miss anything that I'm saying, I'm going to have it all linked up down in the description. I'm also going to throw in some alternatives so that whatever budget you're at, you're going to find something to help you make your dream console setup. And if you're one of the people that's asked about my favorite hoodie, it's the 10-year hoodie from Huckberry. I'll link that up down in the description as well. So the thinking behind this video is that when you're gaming on a console, you basically do four main things. You look, you listen, you play, and you sit. That's pretty basic, right? But how can you take each of those things and push them to the max and make them as good as humanly possible? Well, let's get started with the TV, because after you've got your console, this is probably the most important thing. In the past, my personal TV has been a Samsung KS8000. Subscribers have seen this in tons of videos. And I really love this TV, but I wanted to take things to the next level for this gaming setup. And what is the next level? Well, for me, it's the LG B7A, which is an OLED TV, which means intense colors and perfect black. If you're taking 4K HDR to the max, then you have to have clear details and colors that really, truly pop. And you get both with the B7A. So what is perfect black? Well, it's exactly what it sounds like. Instead of some TVs dimming areas of the screen, this TV and other TVs with this technology can actually turn off individual pixels so that no light is coming through. And that makes the surrounding colors just jump off the screen right at your face. If you do a little research online, it won't take you long to find that this exact TV and several other LGs that are kind of a little above or below this model are highly recommended for gaming. Because aside from the active HDR and Dolby Vision, this thing is super responsive thanks to low input lag and low motion blur. 21 millisecond input lag in game mode in 4K HDR with this picture quality, I'll take it. And no matter what your viewing angle is, you're gonna get a great picture. And I have to say that I really like the menu interface. At first, it took me a little while to get used to coming from Samsung because I just had to readjust. But from the second that I started setting this thing up, I could tell that it really had some personality. Like really, it's got a personality. And that's cool, I like it. All right, so that's why I got it. But would I recommend it to you? And that's an easy answer. Definitely. The only kind of drawback here is that OLED is still pretty expensive, but like they say, you do get what you pay for. And again, if you want something in a different budget range, check out the links in the description. So the next question is, can this thing make you a better gamer? Or let's just say TV upgrades in general. And this is tough because I feel like I was already doing pretty well on the Samsung and nothing really changed. At least I haven't noticed it so far when I upgraded to this thing in terms of how good I was. So I'm gonna have to say probably not, although I do seem to be enjoying it better. Let's move on to the controller next, which is the SCUF Infinity 1. Now Xbox is coming out with a brand new Elite controller. I've noticed you can't even buy the old one hardly anywhere. The rumors are all over the place. I'm interested to see what that's gonna be like, but for right now, this is the most professional controller that you can pretty much get. Like seriously, this is what 90% of professional gamers use when real money's on the line. Why? Because it's modular. You can change the thumbstick length and the shape, and you can adjust the triggers, and you can remap the paddle configurations on the back. Now, if anything that I just said sounds like I'm talking a foreign language, then you're probably a casual gamer, which is fine. But let me tell you, Mr. or Mrs. Casual Gamer, why these things actually matter. The hair triggers and the paddles matter because they can save you time. Splitting seconds to jump or shoot or move is everything when you're competing. So even if you're just playing online and you're not in a tournament or anything, but you wanna be the best, then this stuff matters. Because it's faster to use the paddles on the bottom, which you can remap to whatever you want, by the way, than to move your thumb to different buttons. And same thing goes with the hair trigger mechanism. Okay, so the first question is, what do I think and would I recommend it? And I think 97% of me was very satisfied with this right out of the box. I love the customization, I love the extra grip, that is very cool. The first controller that I got did have a little issue, like a bug or a glitch with the sprint function, but once that was solved, then it was fine. So would that keep me from recommending this at all? No. In fact, just owning this thing makes you feel like a better gamer. It just does. And question number two, will it actually make you a better gamer? Then the answer is definitely. Like, if you're looking for a little bit of an edge, because sometimes that's what really matters, this is definitely gonna make a difference, especially if you take the time to really personalize every last detail. Next up is the gaming headset. And I chose to go with the SteelSeries Arctis 7, again, because so many people seem to recommend this as the best of the best. There is a lot to like here, but as an Xbox owner, there was one thing that I found really frustrating. I'm gonna save that to the end. Let's talk about the good stuff first. First of all, the sound is great. It's DTS 7.1 surround. And let me just say, if you're a super casual gamer and you just use your TV's built-in speakers, wearing a headset will be a huge upgrade for you. It's like the difference between 1080p HD and 4K HDR, but for your ears. Seriously, you hear all kinds of sounds that you never pick up on otherwise, especially with these, and you'll also be more competitive in certain games because you'll be more aware of your immediate surroundings. But this headset is super comfy. Wearing it is like wearing ear pillows. So if you're gonna game for hours at a time, this is a really great option. The headband here is really different too. There's no adjusting or anything. You just put it on and it fits comfortably. And check this out, it's got a retractable mic, so if you want to chat or you don't, you can just use it or not. Now, I know at this point it sounds like I'm raving about this headset, but there's one thing that really bugs me, and it's this. These are wireless headphones, but not if you're an Xbox owner. They work wirelessly with the PlayStation, they work with the PC, but you have to plug it in to your controller if you're on an Xbox. So would I recommend these? Well, I think the answer for the most part is yeah, because the features are great, they're super comfortable, they sound really great, but I just wish that I could use these wirelessly with my Xbox. Wouldn't stop me from owning it though. As far as I'm concerned, this is my gaming headset moving into the future. Can it make you a better gamer? If you're coming from no headset, then oh yeah, definitely. If you're coming from another headset, especially another decent one, I don't know, it might be more convenient and maybe a little more comfortable. So that brings us to the last item of this setup, which is the X-Rocker H3 gaming chair. Now wait, I know you've heard of gaming chairs for like a PC gaming setup, like the amazing Secret Lab Omega that I've got sitting right over here, but a gaming chair for your living room, that's a whole different thing. So what makes it a gaming chair in the first place? Well, it's got a 4.1 surround sound system built right in with a subwoofer that lets you feel the games that you're playing. And I mean, this isn't just for gaming. You could just use this to watch TV or movies too. Now, aside from the separated volume and bass controls, there are two really great features. Number one, it's wireless. Number two, it folds up for easy storage, so you can get it out of the way when you're not gaming. So is it comfortable? That's kind of the main thing here. And the answer is, it's not quite as comfy as I imagined it when I saw the pictures. It's cushy enough, so it feels good down there, but when you're watching something on the screen, like the viewing angle's a little bit off, so you might kind of get like a sore neck or something versus just sitting on the couch. And does it sound good? It's not going to blow away an audio file, but for gaming, if you don't want to wear a headset but still want more immersion in terms of audio, then yeah, it's pretty nice that way. The big question is, would I recommend this to you to pick up as a new gaming chair? I'm gonna have to say no, probably not on this one, because it's interesting. I mean, it's fun if you just have money to blow, but it's really not necessary, I wouldn't say. And will it make you a better gamer? No, not at all. That's pretty much it for this video. If you guys have questions about any of these components, feel free to let me know. Again, check out the description if I talk too fast and you miss what I was saying. And I'll catch you in the next video, which is gonna be next Thursday at 8 p.m. Eastern. Later.